Hi all. Welcome to the next part in our series of videos on linear spaces for manifolds. In this video, we're going to talk about the linear space of functionals that map vectors to scalars, and the dual space Vn star of the vector space Vn. In previous videos, over the last year, we've discussed the index calculus of tensors and vectors, where you have contravariant components of a vector, x with a superscript, xk, and covariant components of vectors, and the metric tensor that converts coordinate differentials, dxi, dxj, these are contravariant differentials, converts them using the metric tensor, the square length. We also earlier discussed a geometric interpretation using Euclidean space and oblique coordinates. So if you have a two-dimensional coordinate system here that is not orthogonal, with coordinate axes u and v, point in the plane can be projected onto the u axis and you get the contravariant component x1 of the vector x and x2. In this video, we're going to introduce a third way to get contravariant components and covariant components of vectors in an n-dimensional linear space, using an algebraic definition. So let's just take a look at this linear space of vectors, a finite dimensional vector space, Vn. So if A is a vector in Vn and E sub k is a basis, and this notation here with the brackets means that this E sub k is a sequence of n vectors, and this is just a short way of writing the sequence E1, E2, through En. So we'll be using this as a notation. Given this basis and the vector A, A can be represented as a linear combination of the basis vectors E sub k and the components of A in this basis are A super K. AK are the contravariant components of the vector A. Next, we're going to need the dual space to V. We talked about linear functionals before, and the dual space is the collection of all linear functionals that map elements of V to scalars. So the dual space itself is a vector space, and it's called Vn star. Okay. So, given a general linear space, Vn, we can define linear functionals that map vectors in Vn to real numbers. The set of all homogeneous linear functionals are themselves a linear space, and we call this V star n. It has n dimensions, and that space is called the dual space of Vn. Linear functionals of vectors obey two rules. It makes them linear. F of x plus y, two vectors, the sum of two vectors is equal to f of x plus f of y. So the linear functional of x plus y gives you two scalars, f of x, and you add them up to get the value of the function on x plus y. And f is also homogeneous, so that if you multiply a scalar times a vector, scalar alpha times vector x, then f of alpha x is equal to alpha times f of x. And f of x, of course, is also a scalar, so the result is alpha times lambda, where f of x is equal to lambda. And if you have a function that obeys those two things, then it's a linear functional. F is then said to be additive and homogeneous. You can generalize these functionals to the case of vector spaces over the field of complex numbers. And in that case, the scalar multiplication is accomplished by factoring out the complex conjugate of alpha. So this alpha bar is the complex conjugate of alpha. Just a note, we won't go into that too much here, but it's very easy to extend this idea to the case of vectors, spaces over the field of complex numbers. Okay, so how do we calculate f of a when a is a vector? Well, if you're given a basis in Vn, you can write a as a linear combination of the basis vectors. A, k are the components of a in the E basis. So let's evaluate f of a. So f of this sum can be written this way, where we use the fact that the a, k's are all scalars, and you can factor them out in front of the f's. So really, you just end up with the action of the linear functional on the basis vectors, en. So if you know what the value of f is on the basis vectors of the space Vn, then you know the functional f for all vectors A in Vn. So f of a vector Ek is the image of Ek in R under f, and this is a real number, call it lambda k. So if we evaluate f on the basis set, we get a collection of real numbers, a sequence of real numbers, lambda k. And so we can plug these lambda k's in here for the f of Ek, and you get that f of a is equal to this sum of products, a1 times lambda 1 plus a2 times lambda 2, and so on, an to lambda n. This summation of products of numbers is called a linear form. And, you know, we were talking about the Einstein summation convention, where you simply, if you have a repeated index upstairs and downstairs, that is defined to be just this sum over k from 1 to n. So the action of f on a vector a gives you a linear form, and this thing here is some scalar, say beta. So the image under f of the basis vectors Ek of Vn is a sequence of numbers, and this completely specifies the functional f. So you can think of this sequence here as the coordinates of f. In particular, the sequences lambda k are elements of the Cartesian product space Rn, and each element of Rn, therefore, defines a unique linear functional. Here it is. The values of f on the basis vectors of Vn are equal to xk's, and for every element of Rn, you get a unique functional f. Now, let's just check to make sure that these f's are really a vector space. So for any two functionals, f and g, they correspond to these sequences, lambda k and beta j. And so if we add up f plus g, these two sequences have each element of the sum is equal to lambda k plus beta k, and that gives you a new sequence of numbers, alpha k, and that, of course, is a element h of Vn star. So addition of two linear functionals gives you another linear functional in Vn star. We also have to have a scalar algebra. Alpha times the linear functional f, if we represent f as an element of Rn, sequence lambda k times alpha, just multiply the alpha inside, and so you have this new sequence, alpha lambda 1, alpha lambda 2, and so on, and that is another functional h in VN star, and you can distribute alpha over the sum of two functionals this way, and you get a new functional in VN star. Hence, okay, so that's about enough of this. You could go into this in more detail, but basically that's all you need to show that the space of linear functionals on VN is itself a linear space VN star. This space VN star, which always exists for any space VN, is called the dual space of VN. It is the space of linear functionals. It's a function space on VN. Now that we have these properties of functionals, we can find a formula for all possible linear functionals on VN. Any vector A in VN can be written as a linear combination of the basis vectors. So if you have some basis E sub k for the space VN, this is a basis for VN, then we can write A this way. Now let's calculate the action of F on this vector, where F is a linear functional. F of A is equal to F of this basis representation of A, F of A. Now we can distribute the F inside this sum. So you can write that F of EK is equal to F sub K, a sequence of scalars. And so F of A then is equal to this linear form, F1A1 plus F2A2, and so on, FnAn, and this is a scalar. Take a look at this series of products. We have the idea that we're taking the vector A and then multiplying by the functional coordinates Fk, and so we're mapping A to scalars. You could also look at this the other way around and say that suppose you have a bunch of functionals, and let's pick one that has the representation Fk. We can use the vector A to map that functional to scalars. So the vector A can actually be a linear functional itself. So you could define a mapping vector A mapping F, an element of VN star, to a scalar. And so A itself can become a linear functional on VN star. And in that case, if you look at the vector A that way, it's called the dual space of VN star. It's an element of the dual space of VN star, and it's sometimes written like this, VN double star. It turns out that VN double star is isomorphic to VN. Sort of an interesting sidelight. Okay, let's look at some functionals, some examples of functionals. What about the zero functional? You know, if the functionals are a vector space, they must have a zero. So the zero functional O bar is equal to the sequence of n zero scalars. You can also have the additive inverse functional if you have a functional f given by fk and another function f prime given by minus fk, the negative of each value fk, then clearly f plus f prime is equal to the zero vector. We have addition of functionals this way. We already talked about that. So the functionals make up a linear space that's isomorphic to Rn. We didn't talk about the continuity of these functions, but linear functionals are obviously continuous functions on the vector space Vn. You could prove that as a homework problem if you want, but if you just think about it, it's pretty obvious. Now, the dual basis. These constructions are all going to turn out to be very useful when we start talking about inner products and the metric tensor. So if you have a basis ek of vn. It turns out there's a natural basis of the dual space vn star, and it is called the dual basis, and we'll write it this way, e bar k. These are vectors in vn star, and this dual basis is called the dual basis of the basis ek, and the eks are all elements of vn. Since the e bar k are elements of vn star, each one maps vectors in vn to scalars. So in particular, if we pick the vectors in the basis ek and evaluate them, we get a scalar, n by n matrix of scalars, lambda kj. So in general, this could be a n squared array of scalars. Now we're going to pick the ek bars such that this matrix is equal to the unit matrix, delta kj. Let's prove that this choice of the e bar k is in fact a basis of vn star. So let's write this out. We're going to define the e bar k as their action on the basis vectors ej of vn. Linear functional gives you 1 if k is equal to j, and it gives you 0 if k is not equal to j. So that's just a way of writing out the unit matrix delta kj. So now we're going to answer the question, is this e bar k a basis of vn? Well, we can calculate the space spanned by the e bar k. So this is a sequence of n vectors, e bar k, and if we calculate all the linear combinations of those vectors, you get a collection of functionals f like this, f sub k times e bar k, where fk is a sequence of length n of scalars fk. All right. So that's pretty good. You know, that is a lot of linear functionals there, all possible values of these sequences of scalars. So let's see if it covers the entire space of functionals vn star. So we can evaluate f of a vector a, and that's equal to f sub k times e bar k acting on vector a written out in terms of the ek basis. So each of these e bar k's is a linear functional, and we have to calculate its value on this vector a. Well, the components of a factor out in front, and so you're just left with the action of e bar k on the basis vectors e sub j. This is equal to aj times delta kj. So that gives you this result that f of the vector a is equal to fk multiplied by the aj delta kj, and that is equal to this linear form. So that proves that the f can be written in terms of the vectors e bar k as a linear combination, and that we get all of the f's in vn star. Hence, v bar k is a basis of vn star. I would say that the first time you see this, it's a little bit, maybe a little bit hard to follow. So if it seems that way to you, maybe you'll think it's very easy and you might have had this in some of your courses. If you are a little bit confused, you know, just get a notebook and go through this step by step, and I think you'll be able to follow it. It's really, each step is really easy. Okay, so let's summarize our results. We have the dual space vn star of linear functionals on the vector space vn as a linear space. So vn star is an n-dimensional linear space of functions, and it is the dual space to Vn. We showed also that any basis E sub k of Vn has a corresponding dual basis E bar j of Vn star, and the dual basis is defined such that its action on the basis vectors of Vn is equal to 1 or 0 evaluation of the Ej bar for each Ek gives you the unit matrix. It's called the dual basis, and it's the dual to the Ek basis. So if you had a different basis of Vn, then you would get a different dual basis. But each basis in Vn has a unique dual basis in Vn star. Okay. Well, I think we'll stop there. Now that we have this idea of dual space and dual basis, we are going to be able to construct bilinear functionals, which are tensors of second rank, and we can get particular bilinear functionals that are symmetric and positive definite, and those are equivalent to metric tensors, and it allows you to define an inner product on the vector space Vn, and that way convert Vn, a linear space, into a Euclidean space. And we'll talk about that in the next video. Well, I hope you enjoyed this introduction. Please leave your questions or comments on YouTube.